The most basic shot you'll face around a green is what I call a bump and run. Now, a lot of other folks will call it a chip shot, and that's okay. It's just different terminology. But I want to talk about the basic bump and run technique, because the technique I'm going to share with you today is quite different than what you're going to see out of most other books or videos or ideas that you'll hear. And it's not that those folks are wrong. I just think they add a little more complication than what is necessary. The bump and run shot is a shot that spends more time on the ground than it does in the air. So it's a very low flying shot. Now, as you've heard me talk about in other videos, the single most important element in having a good short game is being able to control trajectory. This is a shot where you want low trajectory. So as I've discussed before, you have three ways of affecting loft or trajectory. One is club selection. Two is the amount of shaft lean you deliver at impact. Three is the face position. In a high shot, you'd want something very different than you would here in a low shot. For a low shot, you want a lower lofted golf club. Now, I'm not necessarily saying an 8-iron. It might just be a pitching wedge or a gap wedge, which is lower lofted than a sand wedge or a lob wedge. But the point is, you want a lower lofted club because you need it to roll more. You need the trajectory to be lower. Two, you're going to deliver neutral to slightly forward leaning shaft at impact because you want to take some loft out of the golf club. And three, you're going to hit it with a square face. You don't want an open face here because you're not trying to add loft. So those are the setup changes you're going to make. Now let me talk about a couple of pitfalls that people make very frequently, okay? They set up with the golf ball way too far back in their stance. They lean the handle way forward, either because they have a very strong grip and a stiff left arm, or because they just lean it forward and push their hands over there, and they get their weight really far left. Now, here's the problem with that. When you do that, you turn the leading edge into a little shovel, and it won't cut through the ground. It will kind of grab similar to that. And I know you guys have all seen that shot out there where the club hits the ground first and the ball goes about 2 feet, right? That's because there's too much leading edge involved in the golf shot. I really want the golf club to strike the ground with the entire sole on the dirt instead of just the leading edge. And so here's how we're going to affect that. We're going to get a 9-iron pitching wedge, something in that range relative to the shot you're trying to hit. If you got a lot of green to work with, maybe you use an 8-iron. If you don't have a ton of green to work with, but you still need to hit the bump and run, maybe it's a gap wedge. I have a pitching wedge here. We're going to set the ball up in the middle of the stance. We're not going to go off the back right toe like a lot of people have taught in years past. We're going to go right off the middle, okay? You're going to take your setup, again, standing to the handle so that the butt end of the golf club points at your belly button or your belt buckle. And you'll see there that when I do this, I have a little bit of forward shaft lean. It's not because I'm pressing my hands forward. It's because that's the way I've set the golf club. And here's the last thing I want to remind you of. In no way, shape, or form do I need your arms to be stiff and rigid, okay? This is not a putt with a lofted club. I need your arms to be soft, and I need them to have some flow, okay? And so I need them to move and bend and move around a little bit, right? As your body kind of works with the shot, okay? So I don't want a stiff body and moving arms. I don't want stiff arms. I want arms that are soft and a body that flows and moves with the shot. When you set it up that way, you can deliver the entire sole to the ground, use the bounce of the club properly. Your arms are soft, your body has some release to it, and you're going to get a lot better with your chip shots when you hit it that way. Let me demonstrate. Ball in the middle, shaft at my belt buckle. I'm going to maybe move my chest an inch forward, and I'm going to have soft arms and a moving body. Okay? Let me show you one quick drill that will help with this. Because a lot of folks make the mistake of setting up improperly and or falling backward and flipping as they hit it. And so I want you to just grab a golf ball, get in your golf posture, and I want you to just underhand toss the ball, right? And when you do that, you'll notice that my body released with the shot. My arm was very soft, and the ball came out very soft, hit and released. I've never seen anybody underhand throw a ball with no moving body or with a very stiff arm. It just doesn't make sense. Try that drill the next time you're out. Manage your setup appropriately to hit it lower. use the bounce of the golf club, and I guarantee your bump and run shots are going to get a lot closer.